Ladies and gentlemen, how do you do? Welcome to my YouTube channel. My name is Mwarania GM. And so on this channel, I want to show you how to separate personal work and professional work using your browser. Maybe you have one computer or laptop which you use at work and at home. And you would want to separate between your personal work, whatever personal stuff you're doing with your computer, you separate it with work-related stuff on your computer. So I want to show you something that I've used over and over, I think, for close to 1 year now. And I want to share this secret with you because I think it will help you get a hold of, it will help you be able to maybe plan yourself adequately and to take away a lot of disruptions during work. So for this case, I'm going to use Google Chrome to show you this. And let me open Google Chrome. So yes, Google Chrome is open on my computer. So every time when you install Google Chrome, the first thing that you see is just a blank screen, a blank welcome screen. And there is usually this person here. This icon here that represents you as the user of Google Chrome. Now this is what we're going to use. We'll call them profiles. So when you open Google Chrome, or when you install Google Chrome for the first time, it has one person called person one by default. And so we want to use this person one, this profile called person one, as the personal account. So it's basically like creating accounts. The way you could have a personal email account and have a business email account. So for this one, for Google Chrome, everything that you do with, say, the personal account, let it be all personal. Everything that you do with the professional account, let it all be professional work, so that you are able to at least put away disruptions, put away anything that will take you away from working. So what I'm going to do is, I've opened the Chrome browser. So I go to the top right where there is that avatar of a person and click on that avatar. It shows me person one and there is no one is signed in. So I click on this pencil tool, which will basically edit the profile. I am customizing. So let me call this personal. You can call it your name. Say, for example, there are more than one person that uses that computer, you can call it by name. Say, for example, Anna personal account. Yes, and then we can even color code it. Let's give Anna maybe, let's do pink, and give Anna an avatar. Anna is a dog lover or a cat lover. Is a cat lover. So yes, let's use that one, and that is done. You have created, see what changes, this changes, and the theme color of that browser changes as well. So basically this is Anna's profile now. You can create more by clicking on that profile and clicking on add at the bottom here. And maybe create another one for Anna, but this one is going to be professional or work account. Also pick a theme color. She used to love pink. Maybe let's do now teal. Yeah. This is now for work. Maybe the the color code, the theme color of the job place is blue. You can choose to create a desktop shortcut so that you are able to access this directory from the desktop or not. So let's create it because just for the show, and click done. Now when you look here at this avatar, you will see what? There is Anna work and there is Anna personal here. So if you click on this one, you can actually customize it further by adding an avatar. Maybe she works in what kind of a place does she work? She works in a restaurant, so watermelon. Makes a lot of sense. Makes a lot of sense. Okay, so there we go, and our work. So let's think. Let's assume that Anna works with Elsie or works with Alex. And so what I do is I add another person here called Alex. And we give Alex, Alex is basketballer. Maybe the theme color for Alex is going to be green. Should we take green? No, let's take black. This guy likes dark theme. So click done. So every time a new person comes, you can actually click here and add that person by their name. And if the person doesn't want to save any data on that browser, you can just come and sign in as a guest. Click on guest. It opens a page where you do nothing else but browse as a guest without saving cookies. Without leaving any traces. Basically, you are browsing. Yes, just as a guest. You're browsing as a guest. So. Doesn't make sense, right? Okay. So when you browse as a guest, basically, this window won't appear. There will be no browser history. There will be no traces like cookies on the computer. After you close all the guest windows that are open, and any files that are downloaded will be preserved. Okay, so let's say now I want to get into Anna's account, close guest, Anna's account, the personal account, and I want to open WhatsApp.com. So, yes, so that is what WhatsApp.com. Sorry, I'll take that later. Say open again YouTube. This, because it's a personal account, this person likes to watch videos. There you go. It's opening YouTube. Still a personal account, so I don't know, probably what would work in a personal account? Facebook, so those three are open. And now on the work account, on a work account, you need to open, say, the Google, maybe Gmail or any other mail server or mail client. This is mail clients, or what do you call them? Yes, so Google is open. So then that is Gmail, maybe LinkedIn for professional connections. I'm not going to log in, I'll just open it just to show you how it works. So if Anna wants to switch between her personal account and the work account, all she has to do is just click on this icon here and go to personal. Now she's working on personal. She can do everything and everything she wants to do here, and then close it all and go back to work. Or work, maybe it's around lunchtime when they just want, people just want to have a fun time. So they just click on this and switch to a personal account, do Facebook. And then 2 p.m., click. Voila, you switch back to work account. Yeah, so basically that is all. You can find very many creative ways of using such an idea where you can separate. If, for example, you have different businesses, and for every business, maybe you have a system that is independent of the other. All you can do, and you're using the internet to access the businesses, all you can do, you can very easily switch between profiles. Say for example, let me show you, for example, this can be KCB Bank. Let me not use KCB Bank, let me use a ABC Timber Yard. You have ABC Timber Yard, maybe customize this to Panda. Timber, this is looks more like Timber. Yeah, let's do that and give it a midnight blue, a theme or theme color. Maybe also add another one. Let's add wildlife photography, ABC wildlife photography. Let's choose green for wild. Done. So now you can be switching between your photography job and your Timber Yard. So click on this ABC Timber Yard, and this you can work on anything that is Timber Yard related. Click on this and go to ABC Wildlife, and now here you can work on wildlife animals. Basically, it gives you some clarity. It helps you to focus. You don't have to be moving. You don't have to be switching between tabs. Oh, which one was the email? Which one was my work email? No. Open different profiles for different purposes. Like maybe it could be different jobs. It could be different people using the same computer. It could be different everything. Just open different profiles, and then you can always switch through and through. That's all for today. Next time we'll work on something else. Let's make work easier. Have a wonderful time. Ciao.